rise to explain my no vote as well. I truly believe that the Second Amendment constitutional freedoms of every New Yorker tonight has been weakened or will be weakened by the passage of this new restrictive gun law. I feel that it was a shame that our governor felt the need to use a message of necessity, because we talk about transparency and we talk about wanting our people within our districts to be able to give us their opinions and to have public hearings and to hear about the process and to make sure it's open and transparent. Yet we get legislation on our desk for less than 20 minutes and we're voting on something through a message of necessity. Law-abiding citizens who own guns are not our problem. Law-abiding citizens understand, know how to take care of their guns, not to be a danger to others. Mentally ill people and criminals who have guns, who will have guns, whether or not this legislation is passed, because they will get guns illegally, most of them do. All of us in this room tonight care deeply about the tragedies that have occurred in our states and in other states. But do you realize that out of all of those incidences, there are males between 18 and 34, and in only one instance, it wasn't mental illness. We need to look at mental illness. When I look at this bill tonight, I see good things. I see how we're looking at Kendra's law and Mark's law. I see how we're looking to give schools money to help them. But I'd like to see the bill split, so in good conscience, I can continue to vote no on legislation that I believe takes away the rights, constitutional rights, of our law-abiding citizens who choose to want to have guns. I will be voting no on this bill.
So what is your next step?
We're in the process of putting up an online petition that people who believe, as I do, that their Second Amendment rights are being diminished can come out and sign up. And we hope to be able to get enough signatures where we might be able to repeal some of the legislation that was approved today. As I said, certainly some of it's very good. Mark's law, Kendra's law, the ability to give schools money to help, you know, offset some of the physical changes and improvements to protect our children. But there are some things, of course, in the assault ban and things like that. And if people feel that way, get on our website and get on our online petition and please sign up.